right, so here he is, one of the greatest welterweights in UFC history, the Nigerian nightmare, Kamaru Usman. Some criticize maybe his risk mitigation late in that Leon Edwards fight, but this man is an offensive fighter. He's got every skill in the book, and we'll see which ones he chooses to employ here tonight.
It's crazy because when he came off the Ultimate Fighter, he was known as a bit boring. But him and Trevor Whitman have such a great partnership that they have developed a style that works for Kamaru, and it works at such an elite level. He got caught. How does he bounce back? This guy, his jab is tremendous. He can knock you out with it. His wrestling and his top control is second to none. Kamaru Usman possesses all the skills in the world. How does he implement those skills tonight when he steps inside the octagon?
And one thing you never have to worry about, the output, the work ethic, one of the hardest workers in the room, in the UFC, and he is at the height of motivation getting back on the proven ground tonight. So here he is, the former two-division UFC champion, Georges Rush St. Pierre. He's the most prolific takedown artist on paper in UFC history, despite not having any amateur wrestling chops to speak of. This is a man who, at least in my mind, turned the MMA takedown into a thing.
Yes, he did. He made it all look so smooth and so great. But it was the striking of Georges St. Pierre that was so good that made you have to be on awareness the whole time. So as the hands flew up, Georges St. Pierre had the timing that was unmatched at the time in mixed martial arts. One of the first guys that was truly able to do everything. Before we had specialists, and then we had Georges St. Pierre, he truly changed the game.
Georges Rush St. Pierre, always ready to engage. We'll see how he handles this challenge. Our tale of the tape for this welterweight championship fight. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC welterweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the challenger, Kamaru, the Nigerian Nightmare, Usman. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending UFC welterweight champion of the world, Georges St. Pierre!
Herbert Dean's in the building. He is the third man in the octagon tonight. All right, so here's the legend, the Hall of Famer, Georges St. Pierre, back on the proven ground tonight. He wanted this Kamaru Usman challenge. Now we'll see what he can do.
He is a massive star. I remember being in Montreal when he fought Josh Koscheck. The sound that that arena made when he hit the curtain was like nothing I have ever heard before. But Kamaru Usman understands that if he is going to be considered the greatest, he has got to beat that star. He has got to beat that man. That is not an easy thing to do. Georges St. Pierre is the man. Let's see who finally gets it done. Let's see who's considered the greatest welterweight of all time at the end of this thing.
All right, the referee not seeing enough action there. We go back to the center of the octagon now. Georges St. Pierre can get one of his patented takedowns, but it all works off of the jab that you saw right there.
It does. I mean, he has a beautiful jab. And I've seen him do so much damage with that jab. You know, I keep calling back to fights, but I remember him and Josh Koscheck. The moment the fight started, bang, jab, broken over the bone. Koscheck in Canada, fight's over. Pierre does not throw a range-finding jab. He throws that jab with malicious intent.
Now inside the closed guard.
And he's going to try to find ways to pass and move to a submission.
Oh, and he's able to land a strike there from the bottom. Nicely done by Usman.
Oh, right in the mouth.
Well, very efficient and effective with the ground and pound strikes here. High-level work by George St. Pierre. Fighter trying to pass here. Ooh, but gets denied.
Gets denied. Great job. Great recognition of seeing what your opponent was trying to do.
Well, St. Pierre's back in full mount.
Yep, got to be very careful there. That was nice. Just be trying to get back to his feet.
Really good job to land these strikes from top position. Oh, great reversal to top position by Usman. Oh, and there's another ground strike for good measure.
Oh, right into mount.
Oh, he's setting up an arm bar now. Oh, that looks tight to me. It's locked in.
Okay, he's got it. That's it.
Oh, how good is that as he gets out?
That is great submission defense, keeping everything short and not allowing his opponent to get the submission victory.
Well, pretty good work off of the bottom here by GSP.
Nice shot there by the champ.
All right, so pretty good damage here with the ground and pound. Nothing superficial about these strikes. They are intending to harm.
Oh, yeah, he's landing very accurately, and he's landing to get damage off. Changing the position.
Oh, big shots from the top.
He's very accurate in the ground and pound, and it's showing because he's landing so consistently.
Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now because you get to make your opponent decide. They try to turn back into you, you can attack guillotine. If they turn away to try to get to your knees, you throw your hooks in, and you got all your rear choke submissions. Now he's going full mount.
Pretty good work with the ground and pound here by Usman. These ground strikes are starting to add up. All right, so he's got the ground and pound game going here. Oh, now looking to posture up, and he lands a big head strike. Nicely done there by Kamaru Usman. Back mount now.
That was a slick transition.
Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by Usman. And there it is, another strike gets through on the ground.
10 seconds to go.
You looked a little sloppy on your takedowns out there, okay? It's time to suck it up, get sharp, and get focused.
All right, so the takedown's the big storyline in that previous round. Let's look back at some of the highlights, DC, and got to be pretty discouraging to get grounded that many times in one round.
Oh, it's so discouraging because all you want to do is let your offense go, but every time you're getting dragged to the floor constantly. You're starting to get fatigued.
Ready.
He's starting to wear on you. Let's see what type of effect it takes on his offensive approach as the next round starts.
All right, so here we go with our next round. DC, you are known for having one of the higher fight IQs in the game, and I would put him on that list after what we saw in terms of the body work there in the previous round.
He did a fantastic job of mixing up his target. Not headhunting, going to the body, making that investment into forcing a mistake later that will allow him to chase his finish.
While St. Pierre's in half court. All right, has the guard closed here. Good work from the top here by St. Pierre. Man, he's killing it on the ground. Another strike gets through.
And there you go. Again, half guard.
Continues to apply pressure here in half guard.
Getting the ball here.
Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just...
The ref won't help you here. Just as the referee will never take a guy out of mount, they will not take a guy off of your back. You have to get him out of his position. Great job landing in the top position.
Oh, nice transition. Flattens him out now. This could be trouble. St. Pierre's got his back again. This pace is just absurd, and he has kept it up throughout the fight. Chance of Max Holloway against Calvin Kattar, punches in bunches.
I mean, being there, watching Max Holloway do what he did was super impressive. So to even list this performance alongside that tells you how this guy is fighting tonight.
Hard ground and pound shot there, and yes, it was hard. Open him right up. All right, he's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground. This is some exhausting work, man.
I mean, it is so tiring to be fighting in this way. So much wrestling, so much grappling, expending all this energy trying to hold the guy down. I mean, no takedown is not fought. No reversal is not fought. Everything they're doing is fought to the very last minute before it gets given up.
Well, that swelling, folks, is not from sodium. That is from a serious ground and pound attack from his opponent. All right, just as we saw a few seconds ago, he finds the home for another ground and pound strike.
Beautiful punch lands there from inside the guard.
Just over 2 minutes now to go. Well, the ground and pound has been on point tonight. Good work here by GSP. All right, so that opened up a cut around his eye area.
He hasn't moved his head well. He was taking shots too clean, and now a cut has opened up.
Well, this is a tough fighter to buck off. Very good pressure and work here by George St. Pierre. Oh, another ground strike gets through.
Dude's in real danger now. He gets hit once again on that swollen area, and you can see the ringside position starting to get a bit antsy. He may take a look.
All right, looks like he's got a couple hooks in here, DC, and defensively, you better be careful. Oh, he's got that arm in tight, DC. Oh, what's he doing? Now he goes belly down.
He turns down to try to get all of his weight on that arm. Good after that.
Well, he's in a compromising spot here, DC. You got to figure out a way to get back to your feet. St. Pierre's right back to the full mount.
Oh, he got to his spot.
Oh, that cut is getting worse with every passing ground strike as he lands again. Final seconds here.
10 seconds. Nice shots landing from the top position.
Man, another one lands. He's trying to pound his opponent's head through the canvas.
Definitely not good. We need this next round. Okay, we need to get back up. He's taking down. Ready to fight? Ready.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight. All right, so here we go. Next round is underway. It looked like maybe we would get a finish by submission in the previous round. Close, but no cigar.
Close, but no cigar. He's going to have to do things differently if he's going to submit this guy.
A lot of top pressure being applied here. All right, side control now. That's a lot of blood, man. I think I can smell the B-positive blood type from here.
Yeah, he's bleeding quite a bit right now, and the blood's going into the eye. He needed to address this early. Now he's about to have to go into survival mode. He has done such a great job of targeting that cut that now he has his opponent in a critical situation. Nice transition.
Ground and pound the hammer, Mark Coleman would be proud. Well, maybe ill-advised to be competing off your back, but he's landing. All right, north-south position now. We'll see how he chooses to proceed.
He's in a dominant position. Look at him attacking the wrist.
Oh, looks like he's got that submission locked in.
Starting to get deep.
Oh, he's out. The fight's going to continue.
Oh, my goodness. I thought it was over. I thought this fight was over.
All right, he remains in pursuit of the submission, but the defense continues to hold up. I'm not sure he's going to be able to find it. Watch the referee right then and there has called a stop to the action. Looks like he's going to call on the doctor to look at the cut, and it is a pretty significant one, DC.
Well, he's bleeding a lot, and the blood is going into his eyes. It's very difficult for him to see right now.
And the doctor doesn't, yeah, he doesn't care about the fans, doesn't care about your feelings at home. That will do it. That cut calls an end to things, and ultimately it'll go into the books as a TKO doctor stoppage. All right, here now, Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, the doctor has called a stop to this fight, declaring the winner by TKO, and still the undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, George Ross St. Pierre.
He's the man credited with making the takedown.